What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Let's Play Death Road to Canada with Dog and Pony. I'm Dog and Pony, and this is Death Road to Canada. We are coming up on episode 75, which is pretty impressive. And even more impressive, we haven't made it to Canada yet. Is this episode 75? This might be episode 75. The horror continues. Yikes. I think I uploaded episode 74 earlier today, and that came out earlier today. And then tomorrow, in like, I don't know, 14 hours? This is episode 75. Wow. 3/4 of the way to my goal. Boring stop. Sorry about that. The group finds an empty spot along the road that looks as good for camping as any. The weather is clear and there's no sign of danger in any direction. Ooh. Giles is paranoid. Do we trust his judgment that we and say that we can't be fooled here, or do we just eat and rest? I think. I think we don't want to be tired, is what I think. He's pretty smart, though. He may be paranoid, but he's smart. You know what? Eat and rest. The group sets up camp in this boring but safe-looking spot. The group eats a decent meal. Okay. Safe. 13 days away. Totally fine. I have a feeling that going to Canada is a waste of time, says Giles. Well, I disagree. Mahuth? Jody is having near-crippling tooth pain. Without access to the precision tools needed, the only option is to pull the tooth out. She weighs the current options. But we already know the only option. Anyway, he can force it out. I used to be a dentist. I saw this once in a cartoon. Ooh, we could die. We don't know her medical. Her wits are bad. Don't know her strength. Don't know... I used to be a dentist. Ooh. Jody ended up having a lot of trouble. The tooth extraction was messy, clumsy, and painful. To make it worse, she pulled the wrong tooth and had to do it again. Jody's hurt, Jody's morale decreases, and her medical is revealed as absolutely gosh darn terrible. Okay, that's fine. We'll be fine. She's not even that hurt because she does have, she's the resilient type here, so she wasn't even below normal max health. Trading on the death, we've got 27 food left. Super great, but it's, you know, it's a pretty decent amount. We're gonna visit the trader camp. We're gonna buy something. I resolved to purchase something. We got carnage weapons and we got ammo sales. Anime, right? No anime. No, thank you. But carnage weapons. We'll get a chainsaw. A particularly intense-looking woman offers to sell you a spare weapon. I only carry the best stuff. All right. Chainsaw. Definitely chainsaw. Okay. And, I think that's good. I think we're good with that. Nothing else here for us, so we'll hop on in our car. And hopefully we actually got that. There we go. Sometimes I worry that we didn't actually purchase something. But it is here in our inventory. Like, you don't get it right away. It goes to your trunk. And I buy weapons so infrequently that messes with my head a little. Do we have no ammunition at all? Did we... Okay, no, we've got ammo. I guess it's just because we're riding in the car that it says zero. That's fine. Okay, 90 of 41. Gotcha. Set zero, it'll be a 41 when we're on the road. Or when we're off the road, when we're in a thing. Next time we stop, I want to use the car battery to power my game console. No. Could have said, like, maybe. This is good. Rainbow Bridge to Valhalla. The clouds part and a rainbow appears. A Valkyrie rides a unicorn down the rainbow. You've been slaying tons of stuff. I've been sent here by Thor and crap to help you out on your quest. This really isn't a big deal, so don't question it. I won't do it. I won't question it. I'll just accept her offer. She... dramatically raises her hammer, lightning strikes it. The rest of the team is nearly deaf and can't see most colors for the rest of the day. Strength and fitness are revealed as pretty darn good, and she joins the team with her awesome hammer. We're gonna start controlling her because she has that crazy cool hammer stuck in a ditch. The car gets stuck in the ditch near a crappy dirt road. The group is close to getting the car out when a roaming horde draws near. Now they must distract zombies from getting too close. Siege alert, there's no escape, very large nightfall, 0.7 hours, try to survive. Alright, that seems like a decent setup. That seems like a decent setup. We got a hammer. Someone gets the chainsaw. We do have... I'm going to say we have enough gas to power the chainsaw. So I'm going to give it to Giles. And hope that he doesn't waste all of that. And then I'm going to go ahead and set Valkyrie as our leader here. And we're good. Let's go. All right, we just need to survive for some time. And that's a piece of cake. That's easy. We got Valkyrie here. No problem at all. We want to loot because we're probably going to end up using our gasoline if Giles uses that chainsaw we gave him, and he probably will. Gotta switch to fighting to maximize our potential here for killing as many zombies as possible. The more we kill and the faster we kill them, the less bad this siege is. When we kill them all, when they're all dead, we are gonna go ahead and loot that car. It's actually like, we're gonna be totally safe. I was thinking about just looting the car while we were doing that, and that would have been a terrible idea. Because now no more zombies are gonna appear, or at least very few, if any. Yeah, we're good here. I think one more swing should take out at least one zombie there. And then I'm gonna go to the car while they keep fighting and get as much gas as possible. We didn't even use any in the chainsaw. Giles had the sense not to do that, which is great. And that's everything. So, and that's all the zombies dead as well. Let's leave. Yeah, perfect. Yes, let's hit the road. What else would we do? We're up to 129 gas. Actually 179. Oh, did he use the chainsaw? Did he completely empty the chainsaw, or am I like going crazy here? Am I delusional about how much gas we had? Okay, that's fine. No problem at all. Glimmer of hope. The group feels inspired after managing to survive that situation. They feel like they are getting the hang of this. Choose a reward for the group. We definitely need morale for Jody. She's feeling real down in the dumps, and I don't want to lose any of our group. So morale and random skill gain is what we're going to do. We got to get some more food. Every day is a great teacher as long as you don't get eaten. Morale up for everyone. Strength, shooting, and fitness. Valkyrie's fitness is now full, and that's awesome. We only have enough food for tonight. We need to get 5 more to have enough for 2 nights. I once saw a bodybuilder throw a car at some zombies. That makes no sense, Valkyrie. You're a weirdo. Valkyrie's morale went down, but luckily we just increased it, so we're good. Crowded campsite. Giles doesn't trust him, but he never does, so we're going to camp with them, and it's going to be fine. The group takes a risk and goes to sleep in the crowded camp. Nothing unusual happens. We eat a meal, and we're fine. A-okay, we're doing this. We just need to get food. Bee trouble? Valkyrie can swat a bee. Okay, she's a little hurt. She's got bad composure, but overall it was better than panicking. Still fine. We need a stop at a grocery store or like one of those Twinkie trucks. Okay, always be looting. Swarm department. We don't want to do a mall rescue. It's a little too dangerous for us. Swarm department is what we're doing. It's gonna have food in it, at least 5. Moderate, calm, late morning. This is super safe and a good idea. We're at a point where we need to play it safe. I think my mouse was on my second monitor for a second, so I couldn't find it. Okay. You do not get this again. Sorry. You lost your privileges, Giles. I thought you could handle it, and you clearly cannot. And I'm sorry that I even gave you the opportunity, if I'm being honest. There we go. Okay. 2 food already. 3, and maybe some more in the trunk as well. Be nice. We're perfect. We're all set. We can leave now and be fine, and we're not going to, because we're going to keep getting medical supplies and everything. There's hardly any zombies here, so this is a really awesome opportunity for us to like recoup what we've lost. Valkyrie finds a magazine in good condition among the ruined magazines and books. The magazine's title is Cool Running. She stuffs it in her pack. Great. Even better. I wasn't expecting to get stat boosts from this, and now we're gonna. Yeah, if we could get another 5 food from what we already picked up here, that would mean we're set for 2 days. But yeah, so honestly, this is a pretty great situation for us. I didn't realize we equipped the gun that we picked up. Wasted 1 bullet. It doesn't matter. It's still surplus to what we came in with. So I'm not gonna sweat it. I'm not gonna sweat those bullets. That was a great pun. I think that alone is worthy of you clicking that like button. And because I think we're gonna get to Canada. Not in this video, but in the next one. Valkyrie's staying alive. We need one more powerful character. And to be honest, as long as we stay up on gas, that might be accomplished just by letting Valkyrie control herself and controlling whatever character has the chainsaw. Taking control of the character that has the chainsaw, that could win us any given like siege. Even, I'd say, the ones right outside Canada. And if we had a character like, I'm trying to think of a good one. Mason? He's really good at combat. Yeah, let's go with him. If we got Mason and we're playing in rare characters mode, so there's a good chance of it, we have a really good chance of getting to Canada. As long as we don't starve. I think our main worry here, our primary point of concern is the random encounters we get on the road where it's just like, you lost 1,000 food and all your ammunition and weapons. Sorry about that. Looks like you're not gonna do anything this time. Oh, you were doing well? Well, now you lost. And as long as that doesn't happen, we are golden. Yeah, this is so much food. We're real short on it in the car, so we're probably gonna have 2 days worth when we get out of here. We haven't found a kitchen yet. Oh no, we did, but there's probably 2 kitchens here. So I think we're gonna get another kitchen at some point. We're gonna get up to probably 12 or 13 food, and that's enough for 2 days. With the one in the car, yeah, no, we're set. I think we're good. And I'm not getting overconfident. I'm just not letting myself lose morale after the absolutely horrible series of runs we've had. Okay, there's not another kitchen. We're only at 10 food. We're at 11 total. Because that's the whole building. Looted here? Yes, let's go. Okay, so we're to 11. We got 91 gas. That's enough to get us a few more stops. And that's fine. 2 medical supplies will help us out. Nobody's hurt, so it doesn't even matter. And we've got so much ammunition, we just need a shotgun. The group now has the magazine Cool Runnings. Who should get to read it? I don't know what it trains. I think it's fitness, though, so not Valkyrie. And whoever gets it, the morale goes up. I'm going to go ahead and give it to Jody, though that might be a waste. Jody gets to read Cool Runnings. She absorbs the contents. Sadly, she ruins the magazine for others due to her grimy fingers. Jody's fitness increases and it's revealed as terrible. That was a waste. We should have given it to Giles, but it could have been the exact same result, so it doesn't really matter. The only way we could have wasted that is by giving it to Valkyrie. Unless Valkyrie can train her fitness above max, but I'm not even gonna consider that possibility, though some characters can. Whoa, it's Will. It's nice to see a familiar face. He is fighting a single zombie, then suddenly trips and falls down in an awkward mistake. He gets really embarrassed when he notices the group. He's a practical mechanic. I think this is the first time we've ever found Will. And I really want to recruit him. But I think it's going to be a better idea to leave him behind because of food. Next time we start a game, we'll do familiar faces and I'll select him to start. I think that's a good compromise. Leave Will behind. Sorry, Will. All right. Sometimes it seems worth it to run past. Yeah, instead of fighting. whatever. Burnt library. The group encounters a library in a town that seems to have mostly burnt down. Jody finds a single book that avoided being really damaged by the fire. What was the book? What? Book rage? Book rage? Guys. Oh, okay. This is a case where I really think it would be a good idea for me to, like, live stream on Twitch instead of doing these pre-recorded YouTube videos. Because I want to say book rage, and I want to be justified in doing it, because right now, if there was, like, a Twitch chat going on and people were like, no, do book rage, I'd be like, okay, if it's bad, it's on you guys, and I'd do it. But, okay, gigantic repair manual. We could fix our car. Self-help book on positivity. We'd have a better attitude. Rhyming children's book. I always forget what that does. Probably. You know, self-help book might be composure, and this is attitude, or they're both attitude, and that was an oversight by the developer. Book rage. Okay. Valkyrie grabs the book and tears it in half while grunting a lot. Yeah, that's what I think about books. Valkyrie's morale increases. Valkyrie's composure decreases. Her strength increases. And everybody else's morale goes down. That was awesome. Terrible stat-wise, but awesome in every other possible regard. And I'm excited and happy that I took that option. We need one more food to have 2 days worth. Now we need one more food to have 1 more day's worth. But Jody's morale went up, and that's good, because now she's not going to try to leave or try to kick someone else out. If she tried to kick someone out, she'd be forced to leave. We want positive morale in the group, and if you're the cause of the negative morale, you're the one that's getting kicked to the curb. Prepared Preppers Magazine. The group siphons gas from some abandoned vehicles and then spots a magazine in one of the cars. It's an issue of Prepared Preppers, the special edition in mint condition. Who gets to read it? On the off chance that this will boost her morale, even though the other magazine didn't, we're going to give it to Jody again. Yeah. This was a hypothetical, at the time, zombie apocalypse special issue. Jody closely studies the firearm tips, emergency medicine article, and unusual but effective common repair tricks. Shooting medical mechanical increased, and we got some gas from siphoning it from the cars. Okay. That's good. That's fine. Her morale didn't go up. She's kind of a jerk. If only we knew about throwing chairs when the zombies first showed up. Yeah. Alright, the group drives into the outskirts of a city. Zombies mill around, but they haven't seemed to notice the car yet. Your zombie forecast is moderate, sluggish, it's near noon. We don't need more weapons. We're set on weapons. Sporting Goods Store might be able to train something for us, but I'm going to go ahead and say office building. Because I think it's more likely to have food in it. The Sporting Goods Store might have had, like, I don't know. You know when you go to Dick's Sporting Goods and you can get, like, the 30-pack of power bars? Like, the big box of them? Or probably even bigger. I don't know. We used to get those a lot in my... when I was a kid, we got a lot of huge old boxes of power bars. We went through a lot of power bars. It's kind of weird. Now that I'm looking back on it, why did we eat so many power bars? I mean, like, my family, excluding me, relatively athletic. I did a sport. I was a moderately competitive epee fencer for a while. For, like, close to a decade. So, yeah, I ate a lot of power bars, like, midway through tournaments, just so I wouldn't get hungry. I would eat near the end of that. Like, I stopped trying to eat. I mean, like, power bars aren't healthy. I'm not saying power bars are health food, but they kind of, like, market themselves that way. But then, after the first, like, 3 or 4 years, I stopped being like, yeah, give me a power bar so I can keep on going. I was just like, give me a foot-long sub just smothered in Italian dressing. And, during, like, the breaks, my mom would go get me a sub, and I'd chow down on it in, like, 4 minutes and then get back up on the strip. The pissed. P-I-S-T-E, I think. Been a while. But yeah. And then I would go back out there with just like so much weight in my esophagus or
no, that doesn't.
Yeah. Anyway. This is going well too. What have we picked up so far? Not much. I mean, we've gotten some ammo, medical supplies. We can safely ignore what they're holding. I really just want one piece of food. That would satiate me for a small time. I thought there was something in this filing cabinet, but it looks like I was wrong and it was just something to pick up. And it's fine. As long as we get, like, someone had to keep snacks in their desk, right? One person here kept snacks in their desk. And there was probably an office fridge full of their lunches that hopefully didn't spoil. When we find that office fridge, we're gonna be set. Valkyrie's so strong. This is awesome. I mean, I know she's not as strong as, like, TLB with his ability to lift cars, but I've never utilized that. I consistently didn't know that until the last... Actually, no, I didn't know that until after the last time TLB died. So if we get TLB again, I'll be sure to lift cars every chance I get and just maximize our victory chances there. Maybe we'll get him in this run. That would have been bad. I keep forgetting that picking something up automatically equips it because I'm just like, why would I want to pick up anything? Why would I want to equip anything other than the hammer? The hammer's great. And the game doesn't realize that I just want to keep the hammer. So it's like, yeah, he picked up grenades. He wants to use them. And no, I don't. I don't want to use grenades at all. This is way too easy. One food. I got it. Three food. Perfect. That's two extras. So if we get it to stop at a grocery store, we only need four if it's too crowded for us to bother staying. And like if it's too dangerous, all we need to do is get in, get four food, and get out. If it's not dangerous, we're even better. Did we already go this way? It's not blinking. Yeah, it's just a bathroom. It's a pretty empty bathroom. This is a pretty small office building, I gotta say. But we got what we came for, and we are out of here. There's probably more food in these apartments, though. Probably more food in these apartments. All right. Kitchen? Bathroom. But it's relatively... Okay, there were two cabinets to loot, but only one of them had anything, and it was one medical supply. Not gonna complain about that. Medical supply is great, but I really hate cabinets full of junk. It's so disheartening to see just the word junk pop up when you're like, all I need is one more food and I'm gonna be safe. And then, no, it's just junk. And you came into this building and you got nothing for it. And now you're dead. I'm gonna carry this out with me. This is a really easy town. Like, I guess we're not that late into the game. That number up there, you see this? That's tripping me out. That's four ones. Just two of them are in a different font than the other two. Or not a different font, just like a different level of alpha. I know it's just like a visual effect. Like the retro VCR film grain effect that they put on stuff for the game. Like when you're running it with all the scratch and all that we turned off a long time ago to save upload size and the rest of our video quality. But, oh, that's really hard to read and it's bumming me out. Where'd my hammer go? I guess I threw it as I was leaving the closet and then it bounced around. I saw the screen shaking. Otherwise, I probably would have been really confused. All right. Oh, okay. This bookshelf looked empty, but it was not, and there was five shotgun shells. I really don't care about shotgun shells. We don't have a shotgun. It's the only gun we don't have. We have two pistols. Give me some pistol ammo. We looted that. I want to go off to the right side here to see if there's anything else we could have missed. I didn't notice the name of the office, just called Dad and Sons. I like that. That's a pretty clever joke. I'd be laughing a lot harder. I'm just not. I,
I can't.
Wait a second. Okay, I didn't see Jody get into the car. I thought maybe she got stuck inside a building. Okay, we're gonna start it up. And just go ahead and drive on out. This has been a great episode. We got 3 food, we're good for the night. We got a lot of gas left. Enough that we could, if we were in a pretty dire situation, use the chainsaw without having to worry about running out immediately. Medical supplies and no one's hurt. A whole bunch of ammunition, even for guns we don't have. Okay. With that, I gotta say that's all for now, but thank you for tuning in. If you liked the video, please click that like button, subscribe if you want to see more, and share it with your friends, because that's, you know, you can talk about it with them next time you see them. I'll see you in the next episode.